Yo, how clutch is LG? They just sent me this custom-made birthday cake. Got like my entertainment set up out in the living room with the LG TV. Me and my wife on it because we just got married a few months ago. Thank you, LG. In the arms of the age. What's up, guys? I'm Random Frank P. Back with episode 143 of Room Tour Project, the series where we show off some of the best gaming setups to give you all some ideas and inspirations for your very own setup. If you see anything you like, I will have everything in this episode listed in the description down below so you can check it out. But let's start off episode 143. First, we have Nick the Argonian, and fun fact, every time I would play an Elder Scrolls game, I would always pick to be an Argonian, coming in with a nice Star Wars themed triple monitor setup, lots of black and red going on here. For those three displays, they are each a 24-inch Samsung monitor, 1080p apiece. And when it comes to the peripherals, definitely a fan of Razer here. And as you can see, all the chroma lighting is set to red to match the color theme going on. So for the keyboard, it is the Razer Black Widow X Tournament Chroma, along with the Razer Tartarus V2 Chroma Gamepad. And we also have the Razer Naga Chroma Mouse with the Razer Mamba Wireless Chroma, which you can switch between, he says, for FPS gaming and other games. And they are sitting on the Razer Firefly Cloth Edition Chroma Mouse Pad. And as for audio, no desktop speakers, but he does have the Razer Manowar wireless headset, which is on his DIY headphone stand. Then heading on over to the PC, still fitting in with the color theme, love that. Even got a little pop figure inside the PC, which is extremely popular nowadays. Little Stormtrooper there. This is the Corsair Crystal 460X tempered glass case, and inside is an Intel i7-8700 with a Cooler Master Hyper 212 Evo cooler, 16 gigs of Corsair Vengeance RAM on an MSI Gaming Plus Z370 motherboard, and an EVGA GTX 1060 superclocked graphics card. I think the Corsair case here is a perfect fit for this setup, with the red LED lights with the fans there just really make it pop out. And to cap it all off, on the other side of the room, he has a really nice entertainment setup going on with a 55-inch 4K curved Samsung TV, which you can kick back here, relax. He also has a PS4 Pro, which is the obvious Star Wars Battlefront 2 edition, along with his Xbox One and a Nintendo Switch, plus some older consoles. So a great gaming setup even on the other side, completing this whole gaming room. So Nick the Argonian with the red and black Star Wars themed triple monitor setup. Tons of stuff around the room to really give it that whole gamer feel, from Walking Dead to all the pop figures and stuff. And as a DIY carpenter, he states, all of the furniture in his gaming room was made by himself. So the desk, the entertainment center, the coffee table, which really just kind of ties it all together even more to make it all personal. Really, really love that, man. Next, we have GKK with one of my all-time favorite single monitor setups. I probably could have fit this in last week with the single monitor edition we had, but this is just gorgeous. I mean, like, if someone told me I had to get rid of all my stuff and start fresh but could only use one monitor, this is what I would go for 110%. Love the white and kind of cyan color theme going on, the prints on the wall, it all just looks so good here. So for that single display, that is a BenQ 27-inch monitor. And this is actually specifically designed for like color grading and stuff like that, as it's a professional photographer monitor. For the peripherals, we have a nice DIY 60% keyboard, which is the Tina 60%. Inside are some white Kale box switches with some cyan double shot SA ABS keycaps, obviously fitting in with the entire setup. And as for the mouse, we have the Razer DeathAdder Elite. Then as for audio, I'm loving this everyday carry here. Off to the left side is the Fio X5 Mark III, which is the MP3 player. In the middle is the Cypher Labs Piccolo, which is the DAC. And then on the right, for his earbuds, they are the Campfire Audio Andromeda S. This is some serious audio game. Then he also has the SteelSeries Arctis 5 headset just for gaming, along with the Fostex PM03 speakers. Of course, all white and black, absolutely nailing the aesthetic. Then over to the PC, this is the NZXT H200i case in white with some really nice DIY detailing here. Inside is an i5 7600K CPU with the Corsair H60 AIO on an Asus ROG Strix Z270i ITX motherboard, 16 gigs of Corsair Dominator Platinum RAM with an NVIDIA GTX 1070 Ti Founders Edition graphics card. Got some custom white braided cables, definitely helps it all fit in, and I really like the detail here that he did with those custom decals inside, just to make the case stand out, make it more personal. Also have the Hue Plus in there for that little extra glow of the teal going on. So I love literally every single thing about this, and I really can't find anything here I don't like. So I will happily switch setups, and I'll definitely be using this as inspiration for any future setups I might create.
Next up, we have Sir Toby, and yes, I just inhaled some helium.
Hold on, let it fade, slowly fading out. All right, it's been a few seconds, and we're back to normal, I think. And this is Sir Toby's streaming and gaming triple monitored setup. As for those three displays, they are from Asus. They're 1920x1080p apiece, but for gaming, they're great because they are 144Hz refresh rate monitors. They're all aligned and they line up nicely with the spanned, kind of out of focus, earthy wallpaper going on. And by the way, if you want a tip on how to improve your desktop wallpaper, make sure you're ready for tomorrow morning's video. You're not gonna wanna miss it. Now for the peripherals, the keyboard is the Rockhat Ryos MK-FX along with the Zowie ECA or EC2A mouse on a massive 80X Ultimate Gaming extra large mouse pad. You can see in the back there, he's got like an Xbox One controller for a secondary peripheral along with his Behringer Q502 mixer and the headset here, the HyperX Cloud 2. Then for the PC, we have the Zalman Z11 Neo ATX case. Inside here is an AMD Ryzen 7 1700 with the Master Liquid 120 AIO from Cooler Master, 16 gigs of some Kingston HyperX Fury RAM on the MSI Crate Gaming X370 Ryzen motherboard with an Inno3D GTX 1070 Twin X2 graphics card. That is one company I have not yet heard of, but this submission comes from Denmark, so that could explain why. And for a peek under the desk, definitely a good job on cable management, nothing really hanging down in sight, and I got a nice little footrest there hanging between the desk. So a nice natural triple monitor setup from Sir Toby. I think we can call it natural because of the, you know, the light wooden desk and the earthy wallpaper. Plus got some plants and succulents throughout the room, so I can dig it. Next, we have yet another triple monitor gaming setup. Lots of chroma going on here with the Razer theme, which seems pretty apparent, but we'll check it all out. As for those three monitors, they are 22-inch Samsung displays. You've got the light strip behind the monitors kind of flashing down to coincide with the color on the wallpaper. For the peripherals, you can see the headset off to the left side. That is the Razer Kraken V2. That's then sitting on the Razer Chroma base station for the headset stand. For the keyboard, we have the Razer Black Widow V2 with the Razer Lancehead Tournament Edition mouse with the Razer Firefly Cloth Edition mouse pad. But you can also see he has some lighting under the keyboard as well as his Samsung wireless charger, which he used to match with the RGB lights behind the monitors. It's all controlled by an Arduino kit. As for the PC, inside is an AMD Ryzen 7 1700 with 8 gigs of unnamed RAM. We got the Asus ROG Strix B350 F gaming motherboard with an MSI GTX 1060 Armor graphics card. Not too much info on the specs here were provided. And then behind his setup for his kind of entertainment station, we have a 32-inch 1080p Samsung TV, which he also has hooked up to his PC if he wants to watch, like, you know, YouTube or some movies and stuff like that. But yeah, lots of obvious RGB going on here. So a pretty nice looking triple monitor setup with another great job on cable management. Definitely comes to life and shines when the wallpapers and stuff is all turned on. Then lastly, but definitely not least, we have Jonathan with a more subdued, but a very nice and colorful setup here. I've said it numerous times, but I always dig the kind of color blending of when purple and blue kind of mix. For his two displays, they are each 24-inch BenQ models mounted on a dual monitor bracket. As for his peripherals, he has the Cooler Master Master Keys Pro S keyboard with some blank keycaps, with the Zowie FK2 mouse on a SteelSeries Quick Plus Hyper Beast Edition. Kind of said that weird there, didn't I? And then for audio, he has the Sennheiser HD598CS headphones. They're going to plug in nicely to the Fio E10K Olympus 2 DAC underneath his desk, which he has mounted, plus one for convenience. And also for his speaker setup, on the shelves above the displays are the Mackie CR4 bookshelf speakers. Now as for the PC, this is the Encase M1. We have this every now and then, and it always just looks so good. Inside's an Intel i7-4790K CPU with the Noctua NHD9L cooler, 16 gigs of HyperX Fury RAM on an EVGA Z87 Stinger motherboard with an EVGA GTX 1080 superclocked graphics card. But what I love seeing here is that mini monitor he has inside his PC, which you can use to monitor temps and stuff like that. I did a video on this, I believe it was in the Cool Tech Under 54 June, so definitely a great little cheap addition to add to your PC. I mean, who wouldn't want want a mini monitor inside their PC. So a really nice, colorful, dual monitor setup here. Tons of desk space and stuff like that, which is great. Some little things up on the walls to make it more personal. And a really, really nice looking ITX build. And all right, guys, that'll wrap it up for episode 143 of Room Tour Project. I hope you enjoyed. Don't forget, check the links in the description down below for all the gear and hardware you saw. Have listed down there for you, as well as some simple instructions on how to submit your setup. If you want to be possibly considered to be on a future episode of Room Tour Project, check the links down below for it all. If you liked the episode, give this video a big thumbs up to show your support. Feel free to follow me on Twitter at RandomFrankP. And last, if you haven't already, hit that subscribe button. Well, I'm Random Frank P. Hope you enjoyed. Happy 2018 NFL kickoff.